Hey there, Uncle Mud here. I am at Gracie's Wellness Center in Northeast Ohio, about half an hour from where I live, where we're checking on this fine rocket mass heater that we built last fall and giving it a tune-up, getting it ready for this coming burn season that's coming all too soon here in Northeast Ohio. It does get cold, and this is a fairly big farmhouse sort of a building. It uses a lot of heat, so she was eager to try something that uses a lot less fuel and a lot cheaper fuel, like scraps of wood that you can buy from industrial waste stream around here, instead of $300 a cord white oak or whatever that she's got to use for her upstairs wood stove. This is about a 5-ton cob mass, designed and built, code as a masonry heater. The local code guys were willing to accept that our barrel is a manifold for our J2 rocket heater and not part of the heater itself, so it can be metal, which is great because it lets off heat a lot sooner than our cob mass does. Our cob mass is our battery that stores heat and then slowly releases it overnight after we've stopped feeding the fire. So we came and checked out our J-tube. We had reports of a little bit of wisps of smoke coming up here between the barrel and the cob, and we checked that out and put a little piece of fiberglass stove gasket along the bottom of the barrel to seal that a little more tightly. And we checked inside of our heater. We had a problem back behind these bricks. You can see in the burn chamber itself where we got maybe an eighth of an inch of erosion on the insulated fire brick after one season. So just from the extreme temperatures of the fire, and our understanding is that happens. And it evens out. It doesn't get much deeper than that 1/8 of an inch. So we're going to run it again for another season and see how that, whether that's true or not, whether we need to replace those bricks. And we can fairly easily. This barrel lifts off, and then these bricks just stack up and then are wrapped with a ceramic wool blanket held in place by hardware cloth. We can unlace that blanket and take those bricks out and replace any bricks that are that need to be replaced fairly easily. But we're going to see how much more they burn down, erode away during this heating season. This design and build was code approved by the county here, and we're waiting for that final inspection. The local handyman, he wants to polish the surface before he puts the hemp oil on it that will treat it, that will turn it from a big block of dusty mud to a polished, beautiful thing that looks and feels like stone, and be like warm stone when you're sitting on it. They're very comfortable. We love the ones in our house. This is one of the bigger ones we've built. And we're very excited to see how it runs. If you want to follow along, you can check out the posts that we've been making about it along the way at UncleMud.com/Patreon and our YouTube channel. And we look forward to seeing you there. Thank you.